Okay, so yeah, basically the way the project's worked, it's designed to capture the flows that come down Station Road as a sheet flow. So most highways drainage is kept shallow by its nature and it sheds to the edge of the road. But due to the steepness of the hill here on Station Road, it's going to be a sheet flow across the full width of the carriageway. And we're going to intercept those sheet flows with these cross drains that run the full width of the carriageway. Once the water's into those cross drains, it's going to pass beneath this wall that we can see in front of us here, under the grass verge, under the pathway, and then head on into the site through this flow control chamber here. So this flow control chamber has a special pollution control valve which we can access from the surface so that people don't have to go down into the chamber should there ever be any kind of pollution or spill on the highway. It also is there for the maintenance so that if there's any jetting or dirt or silt being pushed back through the cross drains and into this chamber, we can then capture that and remove that safely without it going down into the amphitheatre itself. From this central chamber here, we're then going to head over that way underground in a 500 millimeter diameter pipe to another chamber before it then gets redirected and heads down towards the amphitheatre. And this other area now, what we can see on the right hand side is it's hard to see because there's some water in there, but it's actually the energy dissipation feature. So as the water comes out of that pipe, it'll be going at quite a velocity. And so it's really important to try and slow that down to settle any kind of sediment or contaminants out of that water. So below the water line there, what you can't see is some very large stone called riprap. It then raises in level and spills over a weir feature, which is just hidden from view there. That is called a check dam. That is another feature to help slow the water. And then it weirs over and spreads down and through into the swale, which you can see is lined by wildflowers, which unbelievably, even for this time of year, are starting to flower. So what we can now see is the water is going to come down from the trees along the swale, and then it gradually comes down towards the amphitheatre here. Just before the amphitheatre, what we can see there is another check dam. So again, that's another feature to slow the flow down that's coming from upstream. Make sure any sediment that might be present is then finally settled out before it spills over the top and then along the spiral filter drain. So the spiral filter drain, it's got a top finish there of some larger stones. That's so that if we do get large flows coming into the amphitheatre, it doesn't actually move them around. So the weight of those stones is sufficient to hold them in place. The water can then percolate down below that and into a drainage blanket. So beneath this beautiful grass finish, what we've got is we've got a circular shaped drainage blanket. Effectively, that is just a layer of stone that sits on top of the geocellular crates. So geocellular crates, for those who aren't familiar with that term, is a term that we use to describe very large plastic crates. Large plastic crates, just like something that you might get your milk bottles in. So we've got about 2 meter depth of those crates below that drainage blanket. And then that's also sat on another drainage blanket. That allows the water to percolate up from below ground should the groundwater rise. So the tank, it stores water percolating down from the top, but it also allows groundwater to rise underneath so that it doesn't float. In the center of the amphitheater, what we can see there is what we call the flow control chamber. It's the kind of rusty orange color there. So that chamber below the ground is actually got holes all the way around its edge. So those holes allow the water to percolate into that chamber from the crates and then to go out at a controlled rate back into the sewer network. The reduction in flow from the water entering the system at the top is roughly around 300 litres a second, but when it leaves during the absolute peak storm, it's at 40 litres a second. So we're saving the sewer network having that 260 litres a second reduction. And the volume that's held back stores here. In the worst case scenario, it can actually then surcharge up to the top of the first step only. But the rest of the steps are there just for amphitheatre benefits.